The Philippine president and his cousin, the House Speaker, forged a new alliance of their political parties, creating a new uni-team for the midterm polls. Katrina Domingo reports.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. will revive the uni-team in the 2025 midterm elections. This was among his statements during the formal signing of an alliance between the President's Partido Federal ng Pilipinas and Lakas Christian Muslim Democrats, a party which his cousin, Speaker Ferdinand Martin Romualdez, heads.
Kagaya ng ating ginawa sa nakarang halalan, ay bubuhin uli natin, formalize uli natin ang uni-team. Para naman, pagka humaharap tayo sa ating mga kinabukasan, malalaman natin na tayo ay sabay-sabay, na nagtutulungan, tayo ay sabay-sabay, na kabalikat sa ating layunin na pagandahin ang Pilipinas, pagandahin ang buhay ng bawat Pilipino. Lumakas ang loob natin dahil ang isinisigaw natin nung kampanya ay ang pagkakaisa, unity. Nakita naman natin na tanggap ng taong bayan ang ating mensahe tungkol sa pagkakaisa.
But Vice President Sara Duterte, the other half of the 2022 elections unit team, has yet to confirm if she and her regional party, Hugpong ng Pagbabago, will indeed join the administration coalition in the upcoming polls. The Vice President's relatives have been vocal critics of the President and the Speaker, with former President Rodrigo Duterte accusing his successor of using illegal drugs. While Davao City Mayor Sebastian Duterte had also called for Marcos Jr. to step down. The Duterte family has also criticized the administration's push for charter change.
Huwag mong pakialaman yung konstitusyon kasi that is good for 10 to 15 years. Unchanging yan. So, Bongbong Marcos, huwag kang ako, advice. Hindi naman kita iniinsulto, pero yung para sa akin, yung performance mo was until now and still is a dismal failure.
Romualdez, who has also been on the receiving end of verbal attacks from the Duterte family, says they are still open to talk with the Vice President's regional party, Hugpong ng Pagbabago, for a possible coalition.
Still open for discussion, and of course, we will consult with, of course, Partido
Pilipino. But
anything is possible.
Romualdez says the coalition is planning to field a full slate for the 12-member Senate race, and possible members of their ticket must be in favor of charter change. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Justice Department will present scenarios to President Marcos Jr. on the possible arrest of his predecessor by the International Criminal Court. DOJ Assistant Secretary Mico Clavano says a legal brief for the president is being prepared in relation to the ICC probe of former President Duterte. But Clavano insists this won't change the president's stand of not recognizing the ICC's jurisdiction over the Philippines. The court is investigating alleged extrajudicial killings in the Duterte administration's bloody drug war.
Aware naman tayo na yung policy ngayon ng gobyerno hindi papasukin ang ICC ay posible namang mag-iba. So it'll have to be a very objective briefer para malaman ni Presidente kung paano siya gagalaw. No? Once the ICC warrants of arrests, if ever, are issued, then he will know kung ano yung mga legalities, yung mga options niya, at yung mga remedies din.
The Philippine Supreme Court declares red tagging a threat to a person's life, liberty, or security. The court's landmark ruling notes this may justify the issuance of a writ of amparo or protection order for possible victims of red tagging. The High Court earlier granted a writ of amparo to former Bayan Muna Party List Representative Sigfrid De Duro. He claimed military officers had tagged him as a Communist Party member. The court said there was evidence the military's actions could put De Duro's life and security at risk. The Kabataan Party List says it is preparing legal action for all youth victims of red tagging. Bayan Muna Executive Vice President Carlos Zarate, meanwhile, urges Congress to fast-track a bill criminalizing red tagging. Philippine officials standing firm, no deal was made with China over the West Philippine Sea. A local newspaper on Wednesday revealed the transcript of a phone call recording allegedly between the Philippine Armed Forces Western Command Chief Vice Admiral Alberto Carlos and an unnamed Chinese diplomat, both agreeing to a new agreement in Ayungin Shoal. But AFP asserts it will not dignify China's claim, saying transcripts can easily be fabricated, while audio recordings can be forged using deepfake technology. The Philippine Navy also believes the issue is part of China's disinformation campaign that should be put to rest.
We will not dignify reports like that. Again, it's a zombie story. Let's bring it back to where it rightfully belongs, to the grave. Anybody could say anything. These stories will be rehashed. We have to understand that today's warfare is a battle of narratives. It's a battle of shaping the perception of the people.
Meanwhile, for Manila's Defense Chief Gilberto Teodoro Jr., the Chinese embassy violated the law should the alleged recording of a phone conversation be proven. The Foreign Affairs Department is now investigating the allegations.
Kung itong statement ay totoong galing sa Chinese embassy na sila ay nag-recording ng sino man sa Pilipinas, sila ay umaamin na lumabag sila sa batas ng Republika ng Pilipinas, particularly the anti-wiretapping law. At sila ay nagumawa, kung totoo man ito, ng bagay na labag sa international relations at labag sa batas dahil hindi sila nakipag-ugnayan sa Department of Foreign Affairs at sila'y umoperate na pailalim.
Now, China, meanwhile, remains mum on the reports Beijing may soon release the audio recording of the alleged phone call with a Philippine military official. The Chinese Foreign Ministry says the Chinese embassy in the Philippines has released details about the relevant communication on managing the situation in Ayungin Shoal. This, as it again insists, the facts of the alleged new model are clear and backed by hard evidence. It also says Manila denying these objective facts hurts its own credibility and puts peace and stability in the South China Sea in jeopardy. The joint military drills between Manila and Washington nearing their end. Ahead of the Balikatan's completion, troops from both countries sank a decommissioned China-made ship, which represented an enemy force approaching Philippine territory. It was only after 2 hours of firing before the ship sank Wednesday morning. For military officials, the drills allow troops from both countries to enhance their interoperability in maritime security and territorial defense operations.
The mission of trying to prevent an aggressor from landing on the Philippine soil. So we are confident that we will be able to do our mandate to protect the country. We are confident we can work well with each other.
Practicing alongside one another so we can learn, you know, how each other operates and how we're going to react to certain scenarios. So we'll continue to prepare. The goal is to continue training, continue to building the partnership.
The annual drills, which involve at least 16,000 Filipino and American troops, will end Friday, May 10. Several of the drills this year were set around islands and provinces facing Taiwan and the South China Sea. Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Chanel Dominguez. Hi, Chanel.
Hi, good morning, Bettina. Good morning to all. So we're currently expecting a cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorm over Batanes and Cagayan due to a frontal system. However, here in Metro Manila and the rest of our country, expect a partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or localized thunderstorm during the afternoon and the evening due to the easterlies. We are currently monitoring a cloud cluster outside our Philippine area of responsibility, and we are still monitoring if it will develop into a low pressure area. Expect a heat index range here in Metro Manila with 40 to 42 degrees Celsius for for today and expect the highest to be here in Dagupan City, Pangasinan, Birak, Catanduanes, and Roxas City, Capiz with 45 degrees Celsius. Yesterday, we recorded a 48 degrees Celsius of heat index here in Dagupan City, Pangasinan. That's the latest here in Pag-asa Weather Forecasting Center. Chanel Dominguez, and good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Chanel.